Hi everyone, this video we are going to discuss about the difference between process and thread. First let's discuss what a process is, and before that we'll start with a program. So a program is a set of instructions which are stored on the disk of your computer, right? And we call such a program as passive, as it is static, it's just stored on the disk of the computer, right? So we call that as active program, right? And when that process is loaded into the main memory, allocated some heap memory, and is in execution, then we call that program as a process. And we call that as active program. So simply we can say that a program which is under execution, we can call that as a process. And process related information is stored in something called process control block. The abbreviation for this is PCB. So the information of the process, like process ID, which is a unique identifier to determine a process, process state, like new, ready, running, maybe waiting state, termination, all these are the states of the process. And the PCB also contains program counter, which gives the address of the next instruction to be executed. CPU registers hold small amounts of data for processing. CPU scheduling algorithm actually schedules the processes for execution. There are six types of such algorithms. Page table information. So page table actually translates the virtual address into the physical address for the process. And we also have the device information. These are all which are contained in the process control block. And this PCB will be there for each process. So examples of the processor, like on Windows, if you take Windows Media Player is one process. Say for example, MS Word is one process. Your Microsoft PowerPoint can be one process. Even your Google Chrome application, right? So that can be one process. So an application again may have more than one process. So, but we can say all these are the examples of the process. Now, what is a thread? A thread is a small portion of a process. So a thread is contained within a process. So we can call that as a lightweight process, as it is a part of the process. So to understand easily, let's assume that this circle actually defines a process, and inside it, we have the threads. These are all we can think of as threads. So threads are the part of a process. So within a process, there can be multiple threads. So this is what a thread is. So an example can be like when we are working on some Microsoft Word document, right? So if we are preparing some documentation, so then a spell checker, right? Spell checker continuously checks for the spelling mistakes, right? So that can be one thread. And we can see the word count when we are typing in the documentation, right? So you can see in the right below side, right? So we can see the word count, that can be one thread. Grammar check, auto save, all these are the different threads in the Microsoft Word documentation, right? So whenever we are working on MS Word, right? All these threads will be running simultaneously. This is the best example to understand thread. So, but MS Word is one process. All these, whatever we discussed, right? Auto save, spell checker, grammar checker, and so on. All these are the different threads within that process. Now let us understand the differences between process and thread. A process, we discussed the definition, right? It's a program under execution. We call that as an active program. And thread is just a subpart of the process. We can also call it as lightweight process. And process require more time for context switching. So context switching is like CPU switching from saving the state of one process and switching to the other process for execution. Actually, we don't feel the user can't see the difference. That will be very fast, the context switch. So we can't actually even feel that switching, right? So it will be very fast, but there is a switch. Just remember, there is a switch between the one process to other process, but we feel that every process is running simultaneously. And threads for require less time for these context switching when compared with the process. And process don't share a common memory. they have heap memory, so but they don't share the common memory. Each process has its own memory. But a thread, as threads are within the process, right? So they share some common memory. Intercommunication between the process also takes more time compared to threads. And process gets blocked. If a process gets blocked, right? So remaining process can continue execution as they are like independent, right? So they the processes are not blocked. And if a thread gets blocked, all of its peer threads are also get blocked. As there is dependency. So that's what the next point is also. Individual processor independent of each other. And threads are parts of process. And so they are like dependent on each other. These are the main differences between a process and a thread. And there are some more differences, like process takes more resources than the threads. And also process takes more time for creation and termination compared to thread. Thread takes actually less time for thread creation and termination. So these are the differences between a process and thread. So in this video, we discussed what a process is, what a thread is, and what are the differences between a process and thread. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.